Today's date, Wednesday, August 27th, 2014, 11:38. Interview with Clint Bearden.
Nobody's super sensitive to video except for behind the scenes. Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
good to
see
you
again. Yeah, sorry.
Give
me a slide
over. Oh, yeah,
I just got
to. You
want to
sit here, maybe?
Huh? No, you just sit there. You're fine.
All right.
I've been asked to look into this for the sheriff, and he's looking into it to kind of get some extra for the charges that Tony took.
Yeah.
Kind of close in everything.
Okay.
So basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to listen to the interview, and then if I have any extra questions for you from my end of it.
Yeah, that's fine.
I'll just ask you.
Is sheriff in today? We played phone tag. I was going to try to catch him just for a second to kind of explain everything to him.
Yeah, he's down there.
Okay.
I know he's wanting to talk to Joey, or show Joey the video or something of that nature.
Okay.
But he's down there. All
right.
I got the video here, and we all watched it yesterday.
Yeah.
Down in his office. For some reason, I can't get it to pull up at all on my computer.
Okay.
I mean, I plugged it in, and it's just not playing. I was going to get you to, like, look at it and talk me through it. But
yeah.
If you don't mind, just tell me what happened from the start, if you don't care.
So, essentially, kind of, before the event, really. That's important to the context of what transpired. Yeah, and if y'all have the video, I'd be glad if we need to move somewhere else. Yeah, I don't mind to.
I was just trying to see why it wouldn't.
I went to the computer right here, and it wouldn't. It's just not. What's going on there now? I know it's crazy.
Going back to you before the event, and this is stuff that, of course, I would tell this in the sense that I wouldn't necessarily, was this going to be part of like an official released record, all of it or none of it, or?
This here?
Yeah, your official report, I mean, I guess I want to say essentially, I don't want to say anything that like the media can latch onto about. Honestly, all this, I mean, between you and I, essentially, to say off the record, all this is because of political campaigns and candidates that didn't want video recording, but they did ask, they said essentially, we don't want it to happen. We can't tell anybody, but, we can't tell them not to, but, the property owner can. So if you would ask the property owner.
That's exactly right. I'm sure, if I came to your house.
Yeah.
And you said, hey, Greg, I don't like that shirt you got on. I want you to leave.
That's right.
That's your property.
That's your property. And all
if
this.
You're told to leave and you don't leave.
And all this 100%, you know, because I guess this is the thing, kind of not in an official capacity. And I'll put, you know, I don't care to tell all this. I want to kind of make sure that, like, you know, that news media doesn't say, oh, it really was, you know, the David Perdue campaign that wanted, you know, the cameras behind the scenes. But everything went through Johnny. And I said, I feel terrible for Johnny. Johnny and Kathy Burt are two of the best people in this world.
They're really great people.
And
but Johnny didn't want video. Johnny didn't want video.
Johnny was the one that requested not to have the video. Now, okay. Truth be told, you know, the reason why
was
because
that before the event. All right.
That there had been a request. You know, Johnny had before the event started. You know. The background detail is that, you know, some of the candidates had some concerns. They particularly had concerns, and this is in Michelle Hester's article today. There were some Democratic guys there that had been following these campaigns around. They had video cameras already set up out there ready to record. They were very concerned because, you know, and if you put this in context, you understand why. I don't think anybody cares about video. No, they didn't have anybody there to video themselves. So they didn't have anybody from their campaigns to video or audio, so they were really concerned, hey, somebody's going to get video, and they're going to take 10 seconds out of a 10-minute speech, and they're going to put that on a commercial.
Totally out of context.
Use it completely out of context. We don't want that if we don't have some legit media here that has the full copy of it themselves. Right. So the request was made. They said, you know, we'd really prefer they not be here. I'm like, well, what do we do about it? And they're like, well, we can't say anything to them, but the private property owner can. So we went, you know, kind of collectively, there's a group of folks talked. I got Johnny, brought him over, and Johnny said, yeah, let's not record. We'll tell people not to record, not to have, you know, not to have video, essentially. And those guys were already set up with their video camera, so they were the only people that anybody knew was videoing. So Johnny asked Tony, to go over and ask them, you know, to not video.
And ask the guys, not the girl that was involved.
Ask the guys because the girl was not set up videoing.
Right.
Ask the guys. So this is early. This is before the event starts. Right. You know, it says, you know, hey, I don't want the event recorded. You go over and ask them, you know, if they'll stop videoing, and you know, and then they actually left. Those guys left the property. They just, you know, one of them, I think, shook Tony's hand and they left. I think there was two. I know there was one. I think there was two. I can't remember, though, because I was kind of all around the farm, right, you know, doing different stuff. But definitively, when the event starts, this lady did have, I didn't even notice it. I did get up, like, I introduced, you know, said, thanks for coming to Burt's Farm. You know, we want to thank Johnny and Kathy Burt for being hosts. And, you know, then introduced Ralph Hudgens, the insurance commissioner.
Right.
I never really even noticed her camera, honestly, but she was very much, I mean, she's sitting from you to I, of the speakers, basically, and she had the video camera, and I went to the side and was trying to think. I didn't really even pay attention to it, honestly. Like, I didn't notice it when I was speaking. I don't know if she filmed me. She had a little handbag, and I don't know if I'm on film or not. I can't remember seeing her filming it, but I wasn't really looking at her. I was kind of looking at seeing who all was there. I went over to the side, and then Ralph Hudgens started to speak. And Ralph Hudgens was the one that really did bring everybody's attention, because he said his statement, and then he goes, who are you? Why are we videoing this?
I don't know why you're videoing
this. Yeah, I don't know why you're videoing this. And then he looks around at people, and then everybody that was there, because Ralph Hudgens before the event had said, there was a collection of candidates. Now, again, I'm not going to say names. There were a collection of candidates that had a discussion, and their staff or the candidates that had a discussion said, we don't want people recording. Because at the time, they were really thinking about the Democrat guys, but they said, we don't want people recording.
So that's understandable. You don't want your stuff taken out of context.
Because of that exact thing. Nobody was there from, you know, the Gainesville Times, you know, to make sure they got it all. So, you know, if somebody said, hey, that's not the real context of what was said. So that's when the policy had been put in place at the beginning of the event. I guess nobody knew this lady was going to record because she handheld the camera. She didn't have like a setup, a tripod or anything like that.
Right.
And it was a pretty, you know, not a huge camera bag. Y'all seen it, you know, it's not massive. It kind of looked like a pocketbook, I thought. Mm-hmm. You know, I guess like, that's what I guess people would have assumed. And so she pulls it out at some point in time, I don't really recall when, and starts filming, but Ralph Legends call attention to it. And so then folks were, he gets done speaking, he was very adamant, like, who is that that filmed? I didn't want to be recorded. I want that video type of thing. You know, why is she recording? I thought there wasn't going to be anybody recording. A couple of the other candidates, campaign staffs were like, we don't know who she is. You know, who is she? Who is she?
Nobody knew her.
Nobody from the campaign staffs knew her, with the exception. So here's the kicker. And I would say, again, I wouldn't want this part to be part of a public record, but essentially right. to say, David Perdue's campaign, after the event, figured out who she was. And they were like, oh, yeah, we knew her. Like, she had permission to be here. But all her staff, before the event, didn't know who she was. But then once they linked the name, then somebody was like, that's Nydia Tisdale. And they were like, oh, you know, okay, well, she's videoed a couple things before that he's been at. We didn't have a problem. But, you know, the tone kind of changed after it happened the way it did. Like, their position. But none of the candidates that were right there collectively. So Gary Black was there. I think Ralph Hudgens, Mark Butler, and a couple of guys from the Georgia Republican Party were there, kind of up at the front. And none of them, like, they're all like, who is this? You know, why is she filming? Is she here for, you know, is she here for the Birch, something like that? So nobody knew. One of the Republican Party guys, if y'all seen the video, one of the Republican Party guys, and I don't want people to know that necessarily, the article says it was me initially. It wasn't me. It was a guy that works for the Georgia Republican Party that went over and sit down next to her first mm-hmm. and started telling her something. I don't know what he said, because he sat down to her and I was still staying on the side. Tony was kind of near me and a couple of the other candidates. We were just talking about it because he was like, I'm going to go tell her not to record. He went and sat down next to her. That part may be on audio of the video. I don't know. The best I recall, because it all happened very quickly, but the best I recall, and we could look at the video and see, at some point in time, I don't think I spoke to her before I went to the Birch. If I did, it was just, you know, to say, please stop recording, and then we went and talked to the Birch. But, because I think that there might have been some point that she said, well, I have permission to record, or something like that. I have permission. So I went and spoke and had Tony go speak. You know, he was behind me to Johnny and Kathy, who were sitting in the audience. David Perdue was sitting right next to me as well, the Senate candidate. And I said, Johnny and Kathy, you know, some people are concerned. They don't want her video and they don't know who she is. You know, do y'all know who she is? And Kathy had said, she's like, well, she came in and said she was with the governor. She was with the governor's folks that came to video for the governor. I'm like, no, she's not with the governor's folks, so nobody knows who she is from their campaign. They're like, well, we didn't give, you know, they're like, we don't want her to video. Like, you know, Kathy never said, you know, oh, yes, you have expressed permission to video. She just said, hey, I'm here to video for the governor. And she thought, oh, she's not with the governor. They said, Johnny and Kathy said, we don't want her to video then. Mm-hmm. If she's not with anybody, nobody knows who she is. And so David Perdue was sitting there, and I asked him, like, look, those folks from the party and some of the other candidates, they don't know who she is, you know, what are your thoughts on the thing? And he said, I'd prefer not to video either, but I would never want the media to necessarily, you know, understand, you know, to know that, because I wouldn't want that, you know, quoted as to that part. So right. Ultimately, the call was made by Johnny. And Johnny said, I don't want her to record. Tell her to stop recording. And, you know, Tony was there, and he said, tell her to stop recording. So we went back over at that point.
Johnny told Tony to tell her to stop recording?
Johnny told Tony to tell her to stop recording. Tony and I were sitting there collectively together
right.
on the side, and he said, tell her to stop recording. Or he was kind of right behind me. And so we went back, and, you know, and honestly, I probably shouldn't have spoken to her, but I basically kind of trying to be a courteous thing. Mm-hmm. Realistically, to say, you know, ma'am, will you stop recording? You know, please stop recording. You know, if you don't stop recording, you're going to have to
leave.
That's
what you had told her?
That's what we had told her. And I think, you know, that may be on the video side, but please stop recording. So I'm the second person that's told her this. You know, officially, after Johnny Burt said, you know, you can tell her, you know, tell her to stop recording. So you
told her that before Tony went over to her?
Before Tony went over to her. And then, because she wouldn't stop, I mean, basically, I was trying to do it without having to have a police officer.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
That's understandable.
Nobody wants to have to put the police in that situation. I wouldn't want to put any law enforcement officer in that situation.
Mm-hmm.
Tony went over then, and you know, and I didn't hear exactly, but I mean, he talked to her for a while and, you know, and asked her, I think made several requests to ask her to stop recording,
mm-hmm.
which had been instructed by, you know, Johnny to do. And then Johnny, I didn't see as far, Johnny had said, you know, told her, you know, get her out of here type of thing, you know, mm-hmm. that thing to Tony. And that's when she, some point in time, like she swatted back at Tony. She like kind of moved back, you know, made a movement towards Tony. Like he's either trying to block the camera, you know, obstruct the camera, and she swats him away type mm-hmm. of deal. Then, you know, then it was out of hand. You know, then she stood up, she starts yelling, you know, this and that, and he got, you know, kind of physical contact. I think Pepper Pettit had told me after the event, you know, he's involved in the county here. Pepper had said he had seen her hit him, you know, out there, make contact with him physically. I wasn't really paying attention. I was just kind of sitting there thinking, oh, crap, you know, I can't believe she wouldn't stop recording, and it's, you know,
and it's gotten,
it's gotten to this point.
Right.
I mean, honestly, I never expected that in a million years. And it's a shame. Yeah, I guess it's a sad kind of state to say that this day and age, if a police officer tells me to do anything, I'm going to do what they said. You know, unless a police officer tells me, you know, hey, stand there, I'm going to shoot you. You know, if a police officer tells me to stop, even if I don't agree with it, I'm going to do it. I'll complain after the fact.
Right. Well, that's just it, Clint. You know, most people, most normal law-abiding citizens, such as you, right? I mean, I would too. I've never in my life had a problem with law enforcement. I always try to do what they wanted me to do.
Yeah.
You know, that's the way I was raised. But I don't know. Some people are different.
And this, I don't understand this lady, had anybody known who she was and kind of her, you know, her modus operandi, you know, that I think at a point it clicked with her to say, I'm going to have to leave this event because I'm being requested. I think, honestly, my opinion, I think she recognized it's a law enforcement officer asking me to leave. And at that point in time, she decided this is going to be a bigger story if I do this.
Right.
So the only other thing that I saw from there, and I'm going to, you know, again, I was completely shocked, honestly, completely mm-hmm. shocked that she didn't stop. It just kind of floored me. I mean, I never thought about her saying, no, I won't stop recording in my life. Tony did, you know, she's making a physical scene.
Yeah.
My wife said she saw this, and I remember it too. I don't really recall him. All I seem to recall of him taking her out, and again, it was really a blur. All I seem to recall him taking her out was his hands on her shoulders. Like, I don't remember, you know, the arm being behind her back until she was inside the barn, and that's because she wouldn't stop. Like, you know, she kept yelling and keeping the camera and...
Right. Can I get you to come over
yeah,
here
sure
if you don't mind?
Like, we'll
and
I'll
start this right here, and you can show me. If you don't mind, I've got one more question before I play this.
Yeah.
You said she swatted at Tony as he was reaching to escort her out. Is that when she...
That's what I... At some point before the camera, yeah, I mean, it all happened very quickly, but I was sitting in the road behind at that point,
mm-hmm.
and I think there was a point that he was trying to, like, obstruct the camera or something, right. And she swats at that, you know, to move. Mm-hmm. And then she stood, and it became, you know, who are you? What is your name type of deal? And she starts yelling at that point. And the next thing that I saw that I personally observed is, best I recall, you know, I don't recall when the left arm ended up behind her back. But he had her by the shoulders, kind of, you know, this escorting her because she was otherwise resisting, you know, mm-hmm. leaving the area. When he went into the barn, I took her camera bag. She had left her camera bag at the chair. You know, obviously, they didn't take that out. So I was kind of thinking, hey, she's going to leave the property. I'll take the camera bag in there so she doesn't have an excuse to have to come back out here.
Right.
So I grabbed the camera bag, went in after Tony had her inside the barn, and... basically, at some point in time, she put the camera down on the counter and then mm-hmm. I saw her, like, position the camera around. Like, she positions the camera and shit, puts her head down on the countertop and then starts yelling, help, help, help. But, like, with her right hand, she was, like, moving the camera around to that side of time, like, as I'm walking into the barn. So, at the time, I didn't really pay attention to that, but after the fact, I was kind of thinking, geez, you know, that seems...
So she was intentionally...
I think she intentionally manipulating turned.
The camera to
I think she intentionally turned, and then she put her head on the countertop. From what I recall, she put her head down then and then starts yelling. I know she only started yelling help after she turned the camera back around and hit the record button to start to make sure that she was getting that part recorded, I suppose. And he wasn't pressing on her or anything. I mean, he just had her literally, you know, I hate to use the desk, but literally like up against this desk, you know, with the arm behind her back, not pushing on her, not, you know, forcing her down or anything like that. And my wife saw that. She came in, she had our two boys, they were running around, and Jamie did, you know, she's done like the little, you know, citizens, police academy and stuff, and she, you know, she's rode with the deputies and stuff before, so she's kind of cognizant, and she said, you know, it's like, she was pretty observant. She's like, I'm always fearful of situations where it's a male officer and a female, you know, to make sure that they're not too forceful. You know, in her opinion, kind of after the event, she was like, you know, he didn't do anything that was to hurt her in any way. You know, I mean, he didn't physically do any action that would have caused her an injury on that side.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's watch this. I'm not keeping you too long, am I?
No. I had today set aside for court, so we're done. So
okay.
Yeah, I got some time.
I just want to make sure I'm not. I don't want to keep
fine.
You too long. Let me get to the video that. There's a couple here that weren't very long that aren't really relevant. I'm going to make sure these are all real ones.
Number 30 is
30?
Yeah. Isn't that what you lost me?
Jamie. J-A-M-E-Y.
She has a cell phone with you.
Yeah,
today,
she's a teacher. 770-519-0055.
And she saw the part where Tony
had her restrained. Yeah.
What's her number again?
770-519-0055. She's a Spanish teacher at the high school.
Here in Dawson?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so she's close by. Pepper Pettit, I don't know what he saw. Have y'all spoken to him? Do y'all know Pepper Pettit? He's in the community. He's involved in like several organizations, and you know, he's involved in a lot of different organizations. He's an insurance, owns an insurance brokerage company. And Pepper had come up to me after the event and said he observed physical contact. And I think Dan Bashan did, it's Gary Bashan's brother. I'd spoken to Dan after the event because Dan was actually standing. You'll see in the video when she's being escorted out. Dan is one of the two next to Gerald Swofford, who's in a wheelchair. Dan sat next to him because Dan had said, "I can't believe that came that way." And he said he thought he saw the contact. I don't know.
Right.
I don't really. I remember sitting behind her when all that happened and just kind of thinking, "Geez, this is crazy."
So at this point right here, there's really nothing going on, right? Nobody's aware.
Nobody's aware. Okay. I mean, you can kind of see people are still, nobody's in their seats. People are still like mixing and mingling.
Right.
I thought
it
would be a pumpkin farm without a giant pumpkin. So
with that, I'm going to turn it over to our
insurance. My first address here. And then after that, it's. We
don't need he's the one that says something about the recording.
The first guy.
Yeah.
Which is not me. The article says that's me, but it's not.
It's
Ralph Hudson.
Ralph Hudson.
Oh, yeah, where Ralph does. But there's someone that comes up to her right after that, like that sits down.
We'll see that part. You can't hear.
Oh, okay.
And then he changes his mind and he delays it. Governor, that doesn't happen in our state.
What time are you
at?
4 o'clock, or
if
4 minutes.
If we can get the majority in the Senate and maintain the majority in the House, Tony Park, hell none did. A little cute listening.
It's about to come up.
I don't know why you're videotaping, but yes, I said that. I'm running for re-election. I have two opponents. I have a lady that she ran for insurance commissioner in Florida. She lost that. Then she moved to Georgia. She ran for state rep against John Burns. She lost that. Then she ran for chairman of the county commission in Bullock County. She lost that. Then she ran for state
court
in
that committee
Bullock
comment.
County.
She lost
that.
You know
that was telling my campaign consultant about her record, and his response is, well,
so do you think he's come up now and already said something to her?
What's that?
Do you think after he says, I don't know why you're recording this, how long was it until someone came up to her and said something?
Pretty shortly after. I mean, he was right after might be right around the time that he finished speaking.
Oh, I got you.
I think it's right around the time that he finished.
Because you can't really hear a lot. I mean, you can hear the speakers really well, but you can't hear a lot of what's being said behind the camera. So
okay. Let's kind of see. I can see somewhat to see if I can remember the timing.
I said, no, Michael, that's not what I'm looking for. I want to keep her string alive. But the funny one was
somewhere,
I was on the 14th floor
after his part, and maybe
was up there, and he said,
because
said,
I don't know when that guy did. The guy, this is a part that was telling us here, Edwards, the behind the scenes side of it, and you know, the collection, if I understand this correctly, the collection of what you're getting is primarily designed for the sheriff's information, not necessarily for public dissemination. Is that correct?
Yeah.
The background story, which I'm going to go explain to the sheriff, because I hadn't had a chance to touch base with him yet, there were very much, truthfully, Johnny Burt or I could care less if people recorded before it started, but there were several campaigns and candidates that were concerned about people recording because they didn't have anyone from their side to record it, so they didn't want stuff being taken out of context. Okay. So you had several of the candidates that beforehand had said, hey, there were a couple of Democratic campaign guys there from opposing campaigns that had their camera set up. You know, this is not stuff that I really would want on public record because it makes candidates and the Republican Party as a state entity look, you know, potentially look bad, and that's not what anybody is designed to do. But there were candidates, so very clearly, though, there were candidates that said, we'd prefer them not be here. We can't do anything about it, and you know, the private property owner can ask them. So, you know, we talked to the private property owner. So that's when Johnny was brought over, and Johnny said, yeah, I don't want anybody, before the event started, he said, I don't want anybody to record, and told Tony, you know, I don't want anybody to record. Now, truth be told, that was very much at the request of Johnny, but it was really at the request of campaigns and some of the campaigns.
But again, that's
but
fine, though.
But yeah, because Johnny could have told, because Johnny could have told them, no, I don't, you know, I don't care if they record, but yeah, so it's very much his decision, you know, and that was, you know, completely within his purview to say, you know, yes or no. And he said, I don't want them to record. Let's tell them not to record. He had Tony go tell them not to record. Those guys left the property. They just, you know, they left. I don't know if Johnny asked them to leave, but Johnny told them not to record, and then they stopped. They packed up their cameras and left. This lady, nobody saw her until she didn't have, you know, she had a handheld camera. Not like these other guys had traditional tripod type of cameras that were set up before the event. So you know that, you know, they're recording, you know, a few minutes before it starts. So nobody really saw her until, you know, kind of it gets started. And really nobody really saw her until Ralph Hutchins kind of points out, you know, this. And so then after that happened, a lot of the folks I told Mr. Edwards, a lot of campaigns, and they were kind of freaking out. Mr. Hutchins, after he spoke, was like, who was that with the video camera? I didn't want to be recorded, which he had said before the event. And that's why Johnny, part of why he made the request. Several of the campaigns, some of the Georgia Republican Party staff had said, who is she? We don't know who she is. Why is she recording? We thought nobody was recording. You know, the property owner had said nobody was recording. My fault probably, I guess nobody announced it per se, but they had told the people with recorders, you know, please stop recording. So at that point, they were like, you know, I was like, well, maybe she's got, you know, maybe the Burts know her or something like that. So I went over to the Burts, to Johnny and Kathy, who were sitting in the audience at that point, talked to them, and Kathy had said, this lady came in and said, and this was in the paper, but she came in and said, I'm here to film for the governor. It's what she had told Kathy. So Kathy was under the impression, and Kathy didn't say, you know, you have expressed permission, but Kathy's under the impression that she's there filming for Governor Deal, which wasn't true. Right. She wasn't there for any campaign. So people didn't know her. And I said, you know, no, nobody really knows who she is. She's not here for any official capacity. So then Johnny and Kathy said, well, tell her to stop recording. We told those other folks to stop recording. Tell her to stop recording. And Tony was right there. And Johnny said to Tony, tell her to stop recording. I went back after that, and I was probably the second person that was on there because one of the party guys had gone over at first just to tell her to stop recording. I don't know exactly what he said, the article says that I went over first, then I went over to talk to John, then I came back. Well, that's not true.
Real quick, Clint, I'm sorry to interrupt. I just want to make sure I get this. The person that came up to her after he had pointed that out,
yeah,
right? Who was that? Do you know who that was? Or was it just... It's okay if you don't know, but...
Some guy from the Georgia Republican Party.
I got you. That's fine.
He's a staffer.
Okay.
I don't know his exact name.
Right.
And I wouldn't necessarily want him to be involved. That's why I hadn't bothered to correct the media article to be like, oh, well, it wasn't me the first go around. That guy went over. I don't know what he told her, and I don't know what he said. I think they were just concerned because she's speaking. I mean, that guy had been on the meeting at the beginning of the event where Johnny had said, tell them not to record. You know, mm-hmm. Tell these people not to record. So he went over and did that. Then I went and talked to Johnny. I go back basically trying to probably... You know, dumb move there, but I went back to trying to basically kind of be a courteous request to say, please ask her to, you know, please stop recording, basically. Mm-hmm. You know, your property owner's asked you to stop recording, please stop recording.
Did you ask her that, or did you tell Tom that?
No, I said that first, and I sat down behind her first to tell her that, hoping to not have to involve Tony, you know, really. But Tony had been, you know, at the Burt's discretion, and he was standing aside. And, you know, when she wouldn't honor, you know, what I said, I was like, you know, please stop recording, please stop recording. She wouldn't stop, and I don't think she, you know, she didn't have a duty to me per se to stop. Although technically the Burt's had, you know, told us both. I mean,
so at this point she's already been told three times. Once by the guy from the Republican Party.
The guy from the party.
You, and then
yeah.
Tony.
Yeah, and then Tony goes up to her after that. That's right, and then. That's where it's just three times that people said, please stop recording. And I don't know exactly what Tony said, per se, because I was sitting back and I just kind of sit back and sitting there thinking, I can't believe this lady won't stop.
Right.
I assumed she would stop when Tony asked her to stop recording.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, apparently not. So,
Did you tell her that the Burks wanted her to stop recording?
Yeah, the best that I recall, I said, you know, the property owner said, please stop recording. Property owners have requested you not to record. And I know that Tony said the property owner.
Did she say anything to you then?
She didn't say, the only thing she said to me was, she's like, be quiet, I'm trying to film this. Was the only thing that she said to me. It was like, she said, be quiet, I'm trying to film this, you're interfering with my video. And you know, and just kind of went back, so.
Be quiet, I'm trying to film this.
Yeah. And you may be able to, I don't know, you know, once you can pick up on the audio from, I know when all that occurred was really right around the time that Gary Black, I guess, was up. No, he was up next after Ralph Hudgens. Well, Mark Butler came up next, I think, the labor commissioner.
Mm-hmm.
So at some point, Ralph Hudgens.
We'll play this.
Okay, he's going to say at some part, and his is not too long, so I said at some part at the end of his, or at the beginning of Mark Butler, Richard Woods was up next. That's when I think the party guy went over there, was during Richard Woods' side.
I got real disenfranchised with what they were doing, and so I started going to the Libertarian Party meetings. I was at the Libertarian Party meeting in Cobb County.
Yeah, then you pass forward past Tim.
But it is a privilege to be the Republican
nominee
for.
So I walked out of the background because that's when Hudgens was actually kind of vocally expressing his displeasure at being recorded at that point in time to a few of the folks. I think Tony might have been there at that point. That he says, you know.
What's this guy's name?
Richard Woods.
South of here, but it is a privilege to be the Republican nominee for. You know, state superintendent of schools. And as your next state school superintendent, again, one of the things I can assure you is that I do bring experience to this office. Again, for 22 years, I worked in the Irwin County school system, working 14 years as a classroom and social studies teacher, and 8 years in administration, working from assistant principal, principal K-5 curriculum director, and the list goes on and on with that. But again, everything was pre-K through 12th grade at the school level. So things that I talk about come from firsthand experience. And because of that, I have that firsthand experience, one of the things we look at is that what are we going to do for our children? And what are we going to do for our school system?
To
make sure that each child has
to go
to our teachers.
Over to the side. We kind of stood on the side at that point in time, and we're trying to determine. That's when there was some discussion. There were several candidates over there on the side, on this left-hand side, like waiting to go up and speak.
Yeah.
So we were trying to figure out, because there was some discussion still, to be like, you know, do y'all know who she is? You know, do you know who she is? Do you know who she is? You know, is she here as your guest? Something like that. And everybody was kind of collectively, we don't know who she is.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's her name? Starts with you. I keep forgetting.
Umberger?
Umberger.
She was completely on the other side. Like, so
who is this? Who's
Linda? Linda's the party chair, and she's
The one in the red that said, I got
you. Yeah, so Linda's the one that's created some issues. She was never involved at any point in the process, so she has no knowledge. Like, she was apparently sitting on the other side of the event. She stormed out after this lady was taken out, like, yelled at Tony and I, like, in the barn, and then stormed out of the facility. She was never part of the pre-event meeting where Johnny had made that request. She wasn't part of any discussions.
She didn't really know anything that was going on in what she'd seen.
Nothing. Gotcha. She has no knowledge other than what she observed and seen.
Our teachers to once again do the job that they went to school to do. It'd be about the child. And do it goes on beyond the doors of opportunity that out.
Somewhere in here, so.
As our children leave high school and
education,
Georgia education.
Y'all ever pick up kind of side audio?
You can't. You can hear it. It's just like a mumble, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it's not.
And everybody, I mean, everybody was trying to be extremely courteous to say, please stop recording. You know, like, please stop. Please stop recording, ma'am. You know, who are you? Because that was one part. I think I asked her, like, you know, well, yeah, please stop. Let's go discuss this. I think I even mentioned that because it's like, I don't know if people knew who she was.
This is Mark Butler, right?
Yes, this is where it meets the fan.
I don't think they gave me enough link
Linda,
to work with.
How was Linda Umberger involved in
this? Y'all excited about this election?
She wasn't. She just came.
She didn't help organize. She didn't
Linda,
have meetings, nothing.
Linda got mad because the governor's folks initially called me. Because like I've been involved with the governor's folks for a long time. They called me week or so before the event and said, hey, we're going to be passing through Dawson County. You think that we could find some place that we could, you know, kind of have you put together a group of folks, you know, put together a little event for us, mm-hmm. have a group of folks to come over. So, you know, Johnny's immediately come to mind. There's been a bunch of events at Johnny's before. Kevin
and it's Kent, a great area.
It's a great area. You know, and Johnny and Kathy are close. You know, I mean, I worked at Burt's Farm, you know, growing up. So it's like, you know, they're people that I've always, you know, stayed close with. And you know, they're always pretty open, you know, to letting folks, especially, you know, Republican candidates, because they're pretty supportive of them. So I talked to Johnny and Kathy. So they called me. I called Linda that day because she is the type that gets easily offended if she doesn't think that she's, you know, part of the process.
Right.
So I called Linda to tell her, hey, the governor may be coming to town next week. Maybe Senator, you know, Senate candidate Purdue. They said the governor's folks said that Purdue was apparently deciding if he was going to pay to kind of fly around the state with them or not, that his campaign didn't know if they were going to do that or not. So I told her that. She's like, oh, how great. You know, got the text messages. She's like, oh, that's great. That's great. And then we talked about logistics. I set everything up at Burt's Farm, you know, to have it there. Johnny paid to put the ad in the newspaper just to say that there was, you know, just to kind of advertise the event. Now, the Republican Party, I think, I don't know if they paid to put an ad in the newspaper either about some event that Doug Collins was having on Friday night at Lakeview Center with Vernon's place, or, and I think that it may have mentioned that too. I don't know because, you know, that wasn't necessarily approved by me or Johnny.
This event here was it advertised?
No. It was advertised only in the newspaper, I think, on one ad that said, you know, come join us, Nathan Deal, David Purdue type of thing, you know. It's a private event, but basically it's open to the public, you know, just like the outlet mall could say, you know, come see Santa Claus, that type of thing.
But they can tell you to leave.
But they can tell you to leave. I took a video camera to the North Georgia Premium Outlet Mall and, you know, and said, hey, I'm gonna film your stores, they could tell me, mm-hmm. well, you know, you can come shop here, we invite you for that purpose, but we can tell you to leave when we want to.
Right.
So that was it. So her role was not, I mean, she had no official role whatsoever. She was just there as a guest. You know, I mean, it was, It was, I mean, it wasn't invite, it was not invite only. There was something about, you know, like there were invitations accepted, that people accepted invitations. One of the articles said that. The only thing I can think of with that is that I think that the governor's folks, the Deal campaign, or maybe the state Republican Party, create a Facebook event post about it to say, you know, Dawsonville rally, you know, come out Saturday, and you could click if you were going. You know how Facebook events are. If you want to attend, you can click to
just
say,
like a lot.
Yes, I'll be there, you know, that type of thing. Maybe I'll be there. No, I won't be there. It's not a formal, you know, oh, I sent this to you. Please, you know, send me your personal RSVP that you'll be there or not. And it was just to kind of, you know, and that was done just to kind of make sure there were, you know, that folks that had an interest in coming out to meet the candidates could.
I'll just let you kind of narrate.
This is very important election. What am I talking about? First of all, I'm going to give everybody a kind of example about the difference between a Democrat-run Department of Labor and a Republican-run Department of Labor. When I got there, we had a very, very loaded Department of Labor. We had what I thought was way too many employees. So we said, you know what? The people elected me to give you efficient government. And we've done that. We've reduced our workforce, not positions, that's the difference. Some people are tricky with that. I'm talking about people there. We've reduced our positions by 31%. We have 650 less people working at the department every day than we had 3.5 years ago. And the good thing about that is, it seems like that'd be bad, but guess what? We're actually doing a better job today than we were doing 3.5 years ago, because we're concentrating on getting people a job, not an unemployment check, because that's what it's really about. Now, there's been a lot of talk here recently about, you know, oh, Georgia is going the wrong direction. Well, let's talk about that really quick. I'm going to kind of give you the numbers. And
I feel like at some point in time, I don't know when, some point in time, somewhere in this process.
Is that Gary's brother?
That's Gary's brother, Dan, sure is. Mr.
Carter, he is very upset right now.
Some point in time,
concerned about the job loss,
the party guy was
3 months,
you know, talking to her.
Maybe around this time frame?
He's not telling you the whole story. Anybody like to guess which private sector has lost jobs over the
May have already talked to her, actually.
That's my private sector. You pretty much answered.
Yeah, I was going to say, pretty sure you had by that point, actually, and that's where Tony had been talking to her at that point. So, kind of into Butler. I knew it was somewhere in Butler that it happened.
What is your name, sir?
But kind of into Butler.
What is your name, sir?
Check. Because that's what it's really about.
Did Tony ever identify himself at that point?
Let's just talk about this.
I don't know if he did when she's walking out, you know, and yelling. I feel like positive that he did when he went up and spoke to her. I don't know that I did. I mean, I did tell her. I don't think I said, you know, I'm Clint Bearden, I'm this. I think I did go up and say, please stop recording. The property owners request you to stop recording. Mm-hmm. And I don't really have any authority to, you know, lawfully remove her though either. So I just sit back. But I'm pretty sure Tony did. I don't recall definitively though. I couldn't really say for certain. So the party guy went up and talked to her at some point in time when Woods was speaking or about to wrap up, and then Butler was about to get up. Sometimes he was talking to her, because as Butler was getting up to speak, I think we were at that point in time, or as Butler was speaking, I think that's when we were having the conversation. With Johnny and Kathy about, you know, who she was and whether they wanted to ask. And Johnny said to ask her to sort of stop recording.
It's a little bump in the unemployment rate. Little Mr. Carter, he is very upset right now about the unemployment rate. He's very...
You can hear
looks
her.
Like, yeah, about 10, 13, yeah. 10 is when the conversation starts.
That's probably with Tony at that point, I feel like. Because mine was from behind her, but Tony was beside her.
Concerned about the job loss we've seen over the last 3 months. And guess what? He's not telling you the whole story. Anybody like to guess which private sector has lost jobs over the last 3 months? That's my private sector.
You pretty much answered it. It has not been any.
That's when she, I mean, basically when that happened, that's when she stood and started. Yeah, she stood, and then Tony, you know, I think at that point, you know, she wasn't stopping recording, and then she stood, and you know, Tony had kind of drove the scooter to the side.
Is that when, did she kind of like swing at him there, or?
I think that she had been, like, he was trying to block the video part right at the very beginning part, and there was, like, you know, and truthfully, it might have been reaction, you know, that if somebody is trying to kind of obstruct you, that you would swap, but she did make a movement in that direction.
Right.
5,000 jobs lost.
What is your name?
And obviously, she's got her hands with her, I mean, she's got her hand free, because he's not like, you know, forcing her behind her back, you know, like restraining her at that point. She's doing that. And I don't know if it, you know, if it picks up, maybe we can see the part where she's inside the barn. I don't know if she fell consistently throughout or not.
There's a good bit of it.
What is your name? What is your name, sir? Identify yourself. What is your name? What is your name? What is your name, sir?
Let Dan and Gerald Swofford, you saw them kind of to the side. Yeah. They had a front-on view of it. So that they're one of the few that were at the front of the crowd that observed it from, you know, most everybody else is behind because she was in the very front row.
Gerald Swofford.
He lives off Afton Road, and Dan Bashan lives off Afton Road.
Swofford. Is that SW or SW?
SWAFFORD.
Okay. I spoke with the owner prior to the beginning. Now, Mrs. Burks, Kathy Burks said it was okay.
This is where she's like placing the camera down and turning it at some part, turning it around. Because I kind of came in behind after they were walking in the barn or in the barn with the camera bag.
To Linda since then?
Let's see. Text message only. She'll talk.
She going to the Democratic Party now?
Try to call. Let's see. Let's get back. I'll let y'all see the series of texts. Starts at Saturday 4:24. Maybe you should not have stated all are welcome in the ad. Now that was, I think, the ad that was in the newspaper. She put an ad in the newspaper. I don't know what her ad in the newspaper said. It wasn't necessarily, I mean, it was just done at her, at maybe at her expense promoting, because Linda sometimes will just do that. Like, she'll just send stuff out because she wants people to come out to Republican events. And she's great when she's sane, and sometimes she's not. It's half and half, honestly. I mean, objectively, I hate to be that way, but it became a public meeting legally the moment you advertised the above. Saturday 7:34. I'm not going to look away from what occurred today. You clearly said the campaign, not several candidates, when I confronted you and Tony, which I guess is when she said that she ran. She literally ran in the barn, yelled at me and Tony, and then ran out of the barn and left. It was handled horribly and wrong. I fought the deal campaign because she doesn't like them, apparently. Tony Wooten and you, sadly, you all have no sense. She received permission from the Purdue campaign, which I don't their staffers beforehand had said, their staffers were specifically the ones that had said, we don't want people recording. And David Perdue himself was not there. Mm-hmm. But after the event, the Perdue, I will say this, yeah, the Perdue staffers quickly were like, oh, once they knew who she was, they're like, oh, she's recording for you. Yeah, we had no problem with her video. And, you know, we didn't ask.
This was after Tony's already been asked.
And this is after the event in total. Mm-hmm. Like, after she's escorted out, then they figured out who she was. And they were like, because, I mean, it's kind of a PR spin. They're like, oh, we didn't know who she, you know, we didn't ask her to be relieved, which they technically didn't, because the property owner did. So, you know, Linda's.
Let me ask you this. You may know a little more about this than I do. Just because you advertise something doesn't make it public.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
It may give you an invitation in. But when you're asked to leave, you have to leave, right?
That's exactly right. Like, you have an invitation in. So, you know, the same. Like, you know, I could invite you to my house. Mm-hmm. I could send you a formal written invitation and say, Investigator, I want you to come over and, you know, have some sweet tea. We'll grill steaks. Right. But if at any point in time, for whatever reason, you could be sitting there, you know, minding your business, and I could say, I don't like you. I want you to get off my property. And once I make that request, you know, you have to honor it. Or if, you know, or if you're doing something, if you're on your phone, I'm like, you know, get off your phone or get off my property.
Right.
You know, then that's the extension of the law to say, you know, I think specifically, you know, that if any point in time, and as far as I'm aware, it can be done by a property owner or the representative, you know, a licensed representative of the owner.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it's probably like a baseball game or a play or any of those types of things.
You don't have the owner of Turner Field, you know, coming to say, get off my, you know, leave the game because you're too drunk, I don't want you here. You know, but you've got his representative, you know, through law enforcement usually. So yeah, the public billing of it, I mean, I guess that the ad itself was just your invitation to attend, you know,
right,
to come onto the property. You know, otherwise the farm was closed. You know, it wasn't during public business hours for Burt's farm.
Mm-hmm.
They weren't conducting business at that time, and you know, it was closed for anybody but for that event.
Right.
It's been real nice.
Please stop, man. We've asked.
So this is what I've come in. Here's, she'll turn, I feel like she turns the camera around.
I am sorry that people are treating you this way.
So she's turning the video camera.
She's trying to record her, huh?
She's trying to record her. And Linda, I mean, she had nothing. I mean, she just, I mean, Linda's prone to overreact.
What's her last name? UMBE or
UMBERGER.
Did, I mean, she makes the comment that she invited her there. I mean, did she personally reach out to this lady?
She may have personally reached out to her to say, you know, I hope you will come. But, I mean, that would have just been, I mean, that would have been the same, you know. I had, you know, Calvin Burns, my friend, I had told Calvin to come to the event. You know, I had said, you know, sent Calvin a link to say, you know, hey, why don't you send him an email and say, why don't you, you know, come to the event Saturday?
Right.
So if she did, you know, it wasn't in any official capacity.
This is wrong. It is wrong.
You've
been asked to stop. Stop. Listen.
So she's okay.
Understand me? Do you know what I'm saying?
He's remained respectful.
He has, I'm entirely. So this is her turning the camera.
I spoke with several candidates and they didn't mind. I spoke with the owner. I spoke with Kathy Burt.
Listen, I'm the owner and I said no.
Mrs. Burt said me that it was okay.
Burt said it was okay. I spoke to her when I first arrived. I spoke with Kathy Burt and she said it was okay.
And then I come spoke with you and told you the owners did not want you to do that. You can record all you want, that's fine. And then you resisted. And then you resisted some more, and then you fought with me.
I didn't fight with you. You're the one who has grabbed me.
This
was
this
a public
point,
event posted on Facebook by Governor Deal. This was a public event posted on Facebook by Governor Deal.
Were you there the entire time?
This was a public event.
No, I stepped out for part of it, so I wasn't there the entire time. I mean, but that was consistent. And the times I was in and out, and I think that the Burts were in there for part of the time. The times I was in and out, that's consistently what, you know, she was just like that.
Do you know who may have been there this entire time?
So when I went... When I went in, I basically went in right after them to take the camera back. I was there pretty much right after. I saw the report that he was getting her to the, you know, I guess the countertop. Y'all been to Burt's, they got the counters on each side. Mm-hmm. And that's where she's at. She's on the one of the checkout line counters.
The one on the left if you're going in the barn.
Yeah, that's right. One on the left if you're going in the barn. So I saw that. I mean, I saw that. I turned after Linda went out. I kind of walked towards the edge of the barn to see if the event was still going. I stayed at the back side of the barn. Then Johnny came in. I think at that point in time, if I remember, I stepped out for a minute just to kind of see, you know, if there was any reaction or if the speakers were still going. I came back in. My wife was in at some point in time, but she came through. Johnny and Kathy, or Casey, their daughter, I think Casey was in the video just a second ago there, and they were kind of in and out consistently through that time.
Casey may have seen something too.
I think Casey would have seen something too, possibly, because I think she came in. She would have seen, I mean, everybody would have seen Tony. Basically, you know, the only restraint that was just like what would have occurred right here. There would have never been any other situation where, you know, I mean, I never saw anything. I'm positive, I don't think anybody else would have seen anything other than her left arm behind her back. Not like in an upright way either, just kind of gently behind her back.
What about any kind of, was there ever any kind of inappropriate touching or anything like that by Tony that you saw?
But he was just standing there. So I never saw anything inappropriate. She still had her right hand, you working the camera. It looks like she may have actually hit the, it actually looks like, I don't know if it missed over her yelling the help part. She may have accidentally intended to hit record and maybe hit the button not to record. That's on the guy's audio, apparently, that you could hear from inside the barn. But that's when I did see, I was there when she was yelling, help, help, help. And he wasn't doing anything to her. I assume that she hit the button to record, but it looks like she might have hit the button accidentally not recording.
Mm-hmm.
Is that the actual camcorder right there? It was, well, I was trying to think, she hit. Is there a button on the side anywhere?
No.
I feel like she had it on something larger. Did she have anything attached to it, or was that just?
External mic.
External mic.
Yeah.
Something. It may have been on that side. There was something that she was hitting with the camera, a button, trying to push a button with her right hand when she laid her head down and then she proceeded to yell, help, help.
He only had a hold of one hand, right? One arm?
Yeah, he only had one arm.
Okay.
Would you say she was, like, just acting?
Yeah, I would definitely say at that point in time it was very much into a dramatical. Because, I mean, that's, I hate to say it, if anybody had known who she was beforehand, then we all probably would have said, oh, geez, this is going to probably turn into a bunch of drama. Because I think at that point in time, I think when Tony asked her to leave, she, just my opinion, you know, you could never, it's subjective to what she was thinking, but my thought is she realizes, okay, I'm going to have to leave this event. I'll just turn this into, you know, a good video. Because she apparently makes her living off of getting people to contribute to her videos online. From what I understand.
A blog, huh?
Yeah, blog. And she asked people to give her PayPal donations for
Does she have, do you know how to get on there?
About Forsyth, .com or .net, something like that. About Forsyth.
And she's the one that she started the website?
She started it. I think I went to it Saturday night trying to figure out, you know, who she was. She has several videos. She does have a video of her getting kicked out of the City of Cumming meeting, which was wrong because that's a public meeting. You can't ask people to leave a public meeting. She has several videos of her getting kicked out of Republican Party events or being asked to leave from Forsyth County Republican Party events. There was something at the Forsyth County Republican Women's Group at Norman's Landing off of 20 there, that they had a luncheon and they asked her not to leave. And so she's got a video of that lady. And I guess that's even kind of dicey because the owner comes over in that situation and says, y'all work it out. Like so they're leasing, they're renting the room from him, but the owner of Norman's Landing was like, y'all work it out. So he didn't say anything, and that lady got her to leave. But that was not the case here because Johnny clearly said, you know, ask her to stop recording.
So on Facebook,
leave.
By Governor Deal, Kathy?
You just talked to the owner who asked you to leave, who told you you couldn't do this here, and you still
didn't. Okay, I'll leave.
Oh, you're leaving now, you're going to jail. You've resisted me, my lawful duties, trying to get you to cooperate. You didn't want to do that. You fought with me, you've wrestled with me, so we're just going to wait and we're going to go to jail. I don't know what else to do for you. I tried to talk to you, I tried
please
to explain to
you. Please listen, I'm not going anywhere.
As soon as you decide to act like you're somebody and stop fighting with me.
I'm sorry, sir, what did you say?
So as soon as you stop fighting with me.
I'm not fighting,
down.
I'm not resisting you.
You're not now because I'm not giving you a choice anymore, but you fought me the entire way over here and continued to fight with me. I don't know you, I don't know what you have on you, and I don't like it when I tell you to stop doing something and you continue to do it. I don't know what you have in that
I don't know you either. You have not given me your name, sir.
And I'll be happy to. You'll see it on
the
line.
What is your name?
To jail.
Tell me your name, sir, and show me your badge.
You've seen my badge.
No, I haven't, actually.
Yes, you have.
I didn't.
Yes, you have.
You did not see me.
Yes, you have.
Please, sir.
Stop resisting. You keep saying you're being nice for your camera.
He has a badge on him when he was at the event, and he had, obviously, the shirt, and he did have his weapon. He sat beside her, so I could see. I sat behind her, so she would not have seen my physical presence. But he was, you know, me to you beside her, and leaning this way to talk to her when he first sat, and then then she stood. She obviously turned back at him with the video camera at some point.
Mrs. Burtz, I spoke with her in
no,
advance.
Ma'am.
I told her I was
no,
here. I was. I have
just
my camera.
Just had the owner of
film.
The place.
Ow! That hurts. You're hurting me. You're hurting me.
I was
really
here.
Hurting me.
I wasn't.
You were hurting me.
All you gotta do is be still.
What's he doing? Just standing there?
He was standing there. I guess he moved the camera because she was still fooling around with the camera with one hand, or I guess she's still filming. Does it go to a next video after that?
Mm-hmm.
No, that's it, so it cuts off. She was saying, she was trying to turn, I think she was trying to turn the video camera back around because that's what she did. Like physically, she turned the camera back around and was pushing buttons. Mm-hmm. It appears she may have accidentally pushed the not record button. But that's where you would have had the audio of help. But I was staying there at that point. I don't know if Johnny was or wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
But he didn't do. I mean, he wasn't doing anything to her.
Well, Clint, I can't really think of any other questions I have for you. Is there anything else you think that we should know, that we need to know? Maybe something that we didn't ask that.
No, I mean, it's just, you know, nobody wished that would have happened. I said we've all had to deal with a bunch of shit this week because it did. And
right.
I mean, as I was telling you, I don't think anybody really ever would have thought that somebody would say no to, you know, law enforcement officers, but people apparently do. You know, I guess that's becoming society today that they don't care, what you're asking them to do. But, I mean, yeah, all I can say, Linda has been, I will say this as an aside, it's not official, Linda has been the main
drumming up person that's tried to, and I don't know why. I said, Linda, she's great on days, she's very passionate, and then other days she's just off the, you know, off the deep end on stuff. But she was the one that immediately, after she left, was apparently outraged, calls Sheriff Carlisle, calls Kimberly Boehm, calls, you know, any other news media that she can, but she didn't have any participation in any of it. Like, she wasn't part of any discussions before the meeting. I don't know if she was even aware that the Democratic guys had been asked to leave, you know, that they had been asked to not record and then left. The only person that really knew who she, that seemed to know who she was at the exact moment that all this happened was Sam Olens, which worked out well for him because he knew who she was and probably figured out this is going to be a news story. Sam Olens, the Attorney General. He's the one that...
he spells last name?
O-L-E-N-S.
Okay.
Because he's the one that made the comments saying, you know, that shouldn't have happened. You know, what are we doing here? You know, yeah, I understand it's private property, but why are we afraid of filming? Honestly, that's probably some political grandstanding because Sam Olens realized, I know this lady, I represent her in this, I know what she does.
He's the Attorney General?
Yeah, he's like, this is going to hit the fan and there's going to be press coverage. So I'm going to put this out there so I can say, I mean, I don't disagree with what he said at all. And I know realistically Johnny Bearden doesn't disagree with all, but for y'all's background info, there were people there that didn't want her being filmed, but Johnny made the call. It was completely his before the event and during the event.
How many times would you say she was asked to stop filming? Just roughly.
Three people, and probably, I easily asked her five times, and I know the public party guy talked to her for probably a couple minutes trying to get her to stop. And then Tony went over, and he was talking to her for, you know, a while, not, you know, not minutes or anything, but you know, he gave her several opportunities as well. My wife, I don't know who saw, and I don't know if Tony said this. I did not see it myself. My wife said she did see it. Tony apparently had been struck in the eye, I think, and that she did see the red, like the red marks on the eye. I don't know who else would have seen that, if the Burts did or not.
Your wife seen it, though?
She did see his eye, because she commented to me after the fact that she saw his eye. That it was, they had, you know, it had clearly been something scratched and hit it.
Did Greg, does he have all your contact info?
No, I haven't gotten it.
Yeah, I'll just say I'll be glad to give it to you.
I think you've answered about all my questions, so.
All right.
Probably end up calling your wife and stuff.
Okay. I'll let her know that y'all may call to tell her so that she'll let her.
Just kind of get what she saw and maybe her opinion on Tony's use of force, that type of stuff.
Yeah, absolutely. Because she specifically said that to me. I mean, honestly, I'm not involved in my wife and she didn't say that, but she said after the fact, because she is, I mean, Jamie knows the sheriff well. I mean, she's been around, you know, sheriff's office, you know, since high school, but she did the little, you know, police academy and got to come ride with the deputies when she was in high school, this and that. You know, I mean, back when...
When's your birthday, Clint?
July 14th, 1983. But she did say that, because she made that comment after we were kind of like floored. She was like, well, she paid attention watching him, you know, move her. And then she was in the barn at some point in time and saw, you know, how he was restraining her.
What's your address?
9304 Highway 136 West.
Dawson,
yeah.
Okay. Phone number?
I'll give you my cell at 706-974-8870. Did you email or anything like that?
CBEAR.
Well, actually, let me give you this, my personal one.
Okay.
It's clint.bearden@gmail.com. There's a lot of politics behind this, which is the sad thing, because like Linda does not like Governor Deal for some reason. She supported, this is background information for y'all, she supported Karen Handel when she ran against him, and then she supported David Pennington that ran against him in the primary.
So in her text, she wanted someone to blame Governor Deal, said Governor Deal was responsible, which couldn't be. I mean, his campaign never said anything about, you know, feeling like they. I think they had one comment. They were like, you know, who is that lady? As the Republican Party guy was already talking to her, one of his guys had sent a text to me. Said, you know, who is that lady? And I sent back a text. Said, we're asking her to stop reporting. And they sent back a message. Said, thanks. That was it. So they never said, you know, we want her removed. But Linda wanted that. And I feel like she was kind of has been out for a pound of flesh from somebody because of stuff.
Trying to pin on somebody.
Yeah, trying to pin on the governor. Yeah, you know, or somebody like that. Because kind of lately, it's somewhat. Somewhat me too, in the sense because a lot of the folks I do work for Speaker Ralston and his law practice in Blue Ridge, and mm-hmm. you know, if you're in politics, you got fans and you got people that aren't fans. And Linda has a lot of friends that were not fans and support the guy that ran against him. So, all right. Anything else for me?
Clint, I think that's it. I appreciate you absolutely. Coming up, man. Thank
Do
you
I still it. Need to give a written statement? Somebody had said that earlier, okay. If I needed to.
I mean, I got all this.
Okay, you're good.
Yeah, I mean, it'd be fine. If there's any other questions that pop up, basically what he's going to do is he's going to do the summaries of all the follow-up interviews.
Okay.
And that'll go over with the original incident report.
Okay.
So my take or my involvement in it is basically just to
make sure proper protocol.
Just do all the summaries, and then I'm giving all my findings to the sheriff.
Okay.
So other than that.
All right. My only preference would be, as much as it's possible, I understand you have a legal due investigation. I don't really would prefer campaigns not to be named, because it ultimately was the property owner's thing. Because we've tried to avoid with all the media stuff is, you know, they would really like to say, oh, one campaign or the other told you to do this, because then they can pin it on them until November. Mm-hmm. But it was consistently, you know, Johnny made the decision.
I think basically what we're looking at is you know, the major questions was she made aware that she shouldn't be recording?
Yeah.
What steps were taken prior to putting hands on her and that type of stuff? How many times was she told to stop recording prior to the whole?
Lots of times she was told to stop recording.
Well, she was told to stop recording by at least three people, and you said yourself you told her at least five times.
I told her at least five times. You know? And I, you know, if and so, I don't, I'd prefer not to bring the party guy into it. I could get his information if we needed to, but you know, I know that he sat down next to her for a period of time too.
Do you think I need to talk to him if I talk to Johnny and Clint and Jamie?
Let's do that as a last ditch.
Yeah, I was going to say, because if his name gets in an incident report, then at some part somebody may tie.
Right.
So I don't know who he was definitively.
What we'll end up doing is we'll talk to, like, you, probably talk to your wife. We'll talk to Johnny, Kathy.
I think Dan Bashan, Pepper Pettit saw physical contact. And then Dan Bashan or Gerald Swofford, I think they would probably have a different perspective on the viewing of what was said too, because they were at the front and looking towards the incident. So
then we'll probably reach out to them, see what they got to say. I have to reach out to her and talk to her.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to use this against you at trial type way.
Yeah, absolutely.
But basically, that's pretty much the gist of it.
Okay.
So.
All right. Did the video itself go into, like, will it be part of the DA's evidence in the case?
Well, that, yeah, we wrote a search warrant to get the video evidence off
the video
of that.
Evidence.
Yeah.
Right.
So that'll be put. I don't know what'll be redacted, what won't.
Okay.
But basically, it'll be turned over with the actual case file.
Okay. All right.
All right.
Awesome.
Thanks. Clint, I appreciate it, man.
Absolutely. Thank y'all.
Appreciate you coming in.
Sorry y'all are having that.
Oh yeah.
Hey Major.
Yes.
Is this this is your end recording. Wednesday, August 27th, 2014 at 12:52 p.m.